Thank you for tuning in into Leo's Awesome 35 News. I am Leo Perez, aka Mr. Awesome.
This is his anchor partner, Joshua. We are going live to New Orleans, Louisiana, to the Mardi Gras Fest.
First, we will turn to our news reporters to hear about the history behind Mardi Gras.
Hello, my name is Alyssa DiCarlo. I'm a third grader at Mrs. Bartle's class. I will be discussing the origins of Mardi Gras.
Hello, my name is Kaylee Wick. I'm a third grader in Mrs. Bartle's class. I will be discussing Mardi Gras around the world.
Hello, my name is Alyssa. I'm in third grade in Mrs. Bartle's class, and I'll be discussing the Mardi Gras in
origins of Mardi Gras. According to the historians, Mardi Gras dates back thousands of years to the pagan celebrations of spring and fertility, including Roman festivals. When Christianity arrived in Rome, religious leaders decided to tie all these popular local traditions into new faith. This was easier than doing away with them altogether. As a result, Mardi Gras seasons became the beginning of Lent, the 40 days between Ash Wednesday and Easter Sunday, along with Christianity. Mardi Gras spread from Roman to other European countries, including France, Germany, Spain, and England. The days leading up to Lent, the people would eat a lot of meat, cheese, and milk. They were preparing for the weeks of eating only fish and feasting. In France, the day before Ash Wednesday was called Mardi Gras or Fat Tuesday. Back to you, Kaylee.
Across the globe, for Lent festivals that resemble Mardi Gras take place in many countries, most of them with Roman Catholic population. Some of the countries like Brazil, Italy, Candola, Africa, and Germany celebrated by having a week-long carnival of festivals. Some of the activities of masquerade balls, parades, and costume balls. In Denver, children dress up and gather candy, similar to our Halloween. Mardi Gras is truly a fun celebration in Orlando as well, like Universal Studios.
Many historians believe that the first American Mardi Gras took place on March 3rd, 1699, when the French explorers landed in what is now New Orleans, Louisiana. They held a small celebration and called it Mardi Gras. In the new year to follow, New Orleans and other French settlements begin marking the holidays with street parties, mass balls, and lavish dinners. When the Spanish took over New Orleans, they banned the rowdy parties, and it remained that way until Louisiana became a U.S. state in 1812. Mardi Gras is now a legend holiday in Louisiana and is celebrated by parades of marching bands, floats of purple, gold, and green, throwing beads, and eating king cake. This year, Mardi Gras was celebrated on February 12th.
Back to you, anchors!
Thank you for the location, parties, and food.
I am Carter. I'm going to show you where New Orleans is located. It is located in Louisiana. The location of Mardi Gras is in New Orleans. New Orleans is located in Louisiana. Louisiana is located in the United States of America. Mardi Gras is a tradition in the United States. Tradition in New Orleans.
In parties on Mardi Gras, people dress up and wear masks as disguises. They throw parades and have a good time, and they dance so much.
On Mardi Gras, people eat a lot. They eat a lot because that is a tradition. Another type of food is the king's cake. They eat the whole day until they start dancing.
Back to you, anchor.
Then let's go to the king's cake. Yum!
A king cake can have beads, rings, and a plastic baby. The colored sugar sprinkle topping on the cake. There are three Mardi Gras colors, each have a meaning.
Purple for justice, green for faith, and gold for power. The king cake had a bean in the cake in the past, but now it is a plastic baby.
The cake is called a king's cake by the three kings to find baby Jesus, and the person who finds the baby in their piece of cake, they would have to buy it the next cake in the following year.
Back to you, anchors.
Next up for the trip, we will hear about the party and floats.
Hello, my name is Judah, and we are going to talk about Mardi Gras. Only the lucky
people happen to take to their house hand-decorated cool coconuts that were from the crew of Zulu. Crew people get the good honor to ride the floats. They will toss and throw beads and those good doubloons and trinkets to the people over the course of the route. Those good trinkets usually bear the member's emblem along with the date and theme.
Hello, my name is Emily. Beads, costumes, and king's cake are all Mardi Gras staples. However, carnival seasons just wonder be the same without elegant. Iconic. The same without elegant floats through the streets prior to hurricanes. Katrina, about 60 parades rolled the through the streets of New Orleans.
The first Mardi Gras parade in the USA didn't happen in New Orleans. It was held in Mobile, Alabama in the early 1700s. The many colorful necklaces that are beaded or thrown from floats are the most special symbols and souvenirs of Mardi Gras. In addition, a lot of cups and fake coins known as doubloons are designed with crew logos and thrown to parade walkers. Back to you, anchors.
Last, we are going to go to the mask and costumes.
Hi, my name is Messiah.
Hi, my name is Connor.
Hi, my name is Dania.
And we're gonna be teaching you about masks and costumes.
People wear colorful masks and costumes to celebrate Mardi Gras.
This is because they do not want to be identified. Some people even make their masks and costumes, just like this one. Costumes are designed by colorful fabric.
People wear masks and costumes to celebrate Mardi Gras.
Back to you, Anchor.
Yeah.